Dana, Brad said that that the loss in 2013 motivated him and stuck with him more than winning in 2011. Is that, you feel the same way? If not, how do you feel on that?
Well, I think that you learn from both of those experiences. Definitely one is happier, the other one is more sour, but yeah, definitely makes you more hungry next time you have the opportunity.
Right side. Z, just wondering, when you first realized what the Stanley Cup was, and were you that kid in your backyard or on the ice or in the street just playing hockey, scoring the game-winning goal in a Stanley Cup Game 7?
Well, I think I said it many times. We didn't get the coverage of the NHL games until maybe early 90s. I remember watching my first NHL game. It was the Stanley Cup Finals because we were Penguins against Minnesota North Stars that time. You know, pretty much the whole country followed Jaromir Jagr, and it was Yuri Irina as well. So that was my first experience, and then obviously after the game I saw the big, huge trophy, and that's the first time obviously I realized that's the Stanley Cup.
Right side, fifth row.
As he, having played with Charlie McAvoy for so long, what sort of growth are you seeing out of him during these playoffs, and are you still amazed at how young he is and how he's able to play with that sort of maturity in his game?
He just keeps getting better. He's obviously a very talented player. His ability to skate, you know, he's got such a long, powerful stride. He can get out of the situations by simply just being able to skate out of them. He sees the ice really well. He makes great plays. And I think just you know, his ability to be kind of involved in the games in all the situations makes him keep getting better and better.
A few more for Z, left side, second row.
And Dana, this is going to be your 14th Game 7 of your most ever. What do you remember about your first one? And overall, what do you take from those 13 games as like a key or to approaching some situation like this?
It's always, you know, fun to play these Game 7s. You know, first time was obviously with Ottawa against Toronto. Very intense. I think that you just gotta realize you gotta lay everything on the line and play our best games.
Front left.
See, Patrice had a pretty nice pregame speech that was effective in the last game. Just wondering if you've made some similar speeches in the past and might you make one for Game 7?
I think that we shared our responsibility. I mean, it's a you know, great group of leaders we have, and it's not that you know, I'm down there sitting at, you know, at the desk and trying to figure out some speech. I think you just gotta go by the feel. You know, I think that we all realize that it's more about actions than words, but obviously we're going to be talking before the game and emphasize a few things.
One more for Z, third row on the left.
Just want to see what did you take in from the reception you got to start Game 5 and have that support for Game 7?
I didn't expect it, obviously. I was overwhelmed by the response of the crowd. Very humbling, and so, you know, so honored to get that kind of pregame crowd being involved and cheering and so on. So you know, it just shows that how passionate the Boston fans are. You know, very much appreciated, and you know, we are so thankful they are, you know, so behind us and cheering us on.
Thank you.